I'll start off the way that we started last time. Was that I find it funny how 6 years ago we all kind of looked down upon drinking and smoking and drugs and everything else as well, and now 6 years later it's kind of like what all of us do on a daily basis.
On a daily basis.
Well, not a daily basis.
You cracked in.
Yeah, I know. I feel like if our S1 cells had known our S6 cells, they would have been judged us.
Pretty disappointed in myself, I would be.
You just spoke like Yoda.
You know, 5 or 6 years ago we were 13, right?
Yeah. 13 or 12.
13 or 12.
I'm not as bad as some people, but 13-year-old Maya would definitely be disappointed. To say the least.
Same with 13-year-old Freya. We'd look down and be like, oh my god, what are you doing? And I'd be like, it's all fine, it's part of living.
When James and that group,
Charlie,
like,
yeah,
smoked weed for us, and we were like,
yeah, we were like, oh, what
even,
bad
like,
people they are.
Year, when we heard people in, like, 2 years above were doing it, we were like, oh my god. Oh,
yeah, I mean, what was it? It was like,
you can't do that. It's ridiculous.
Leaked!
They got leaked like 4 times!
And he's like, no one brings it up ever! We've seen his car!
You got addicted to... So...
Crack.
I don't really,
I would say,
I wouldn't push the whole drug taking.
Yeah.
But
I'm sure... would.
I'm sure other words
I'm sure he's really on board with that.
Do you remember, when did weed? Before France.
Oh, before... Yeah, before France. And we were telling him, like, as we were going on to plane, you're like, yeah. You know, they have, like, sniffer dogs at the airport. And he was, like, bricking himself. In Barcelona.
Oh, yeah.
James and Blair were in the vape store. And me, you and Adam were standing outside.
Mr. Robertson and Mr. Allen come along.
On.
And they're like, they walk right up to us. And we can see in the window of the shop where they've got, like, cannabis on display.
Yeah.
And we can see them. And Mr. Allen and Mr. Robertson just completely miss them, and we're like bricking ourselves, like,
we're like,
fuck, they're gonna.
We're like, all right, boys, and we're like
12 years old.
They were just buying vapes, weren't they?
I think so.
How poor of a job that we all did with the leaf file this year and fifth year.
I would have been.
That's because they like policed it heavily. Do you remember? Like first, second, maybe third. I can't remember much of third year, but first and second year, like it was nobody. They didn't give a shit. Leaf piled everyone, yeah.
The only thing I remember
but,
with the leaf pile.
No, but like fourth, fifth, and sixth year for us, they were like, they all like stood around outside as soon as it was like,
it's kind of gay.
All of autumn, when all the leaves were around, they were like, they got all the jannies and shit to clean it up because they were like, nah, we don't want any of this happening this year.
They made sure to cut it off.
And also because we really couldn't really be arsed. Or I couldn't be arsed picking up, like, what? Like,
but they're such fat kids now. Like,
that's because I wasn't. That's because I wasn't there. To be fair.
Oh yeah, of course you
would. If I
you
would have done fuck all.
If I was there, everyone would be leaf piled. Yeah. Like if I say someone's leaf piled, they're leaf piled.
That was pretty.
Quite disappointing considering the previous years. I used to be scared shitless.
Cameron, why were you scared? You're a fat boy.
Because I was.
They couldn't pick you up.
Well, I was 12, you mean?
Yeah, but they couldn't pick you up. Look at it.
Fat.
I mean, I'm sure Cameron was never scared of the leaf pile.
It's the same with like with the snowballs as well. It's like, oh, you can throw snowballs in like the grass, and then someone got like a rock off the head, and it was like, okay, no snowballs at all. And then Miss Murison and fucking Mr. Allen and all that, and Mr. Martin, they'd all come out and be like, no, you're not allowed to do that. But the leaf pile used to be brutal. Like when we were in first year, people get their heads stomped on, their heads kicked in, and fucking couldn't breathe because you get smashed in the ribs. But it was poor from us. It was.
Sam Andrews as well got his head kicked in.
That guy, he got done. He got wrecked.
Crucified.
Yeah, he got wrecked.
Probably.
I think he's in jail.
What else have I got to say?
Probably so much shit.
Over the 6 years, do you feel like there you've had a point where you've actually like matured at all?
I feel like we've matured to an extent of not being overtly offensive to every single person we walk past in the street.
there was kind of like a thing in the group of our friends, especially where like.
Especially
just, just sort of like everything offensive was just like funny, and we just like would be like horrible, and like looking on back on that, I cringe so hard, and I just like thinking about the way we used to like act and like do shit in school, or like scream, and I was just it's just awful.
I don't know
maybe about like maturing, but I just remember all of a sudden feeling really grown up when we had to like exam. Like, mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Like,
I feel
serious.
Like in a way, yes.
Yeah.
Because like none of us have been sent to guidance since fourth year, so progression.
Exactly.
So I would say that's a win.
Then I also still feel like my S2 self.
Mm-hmm. True. Yeah.
There was that one time we teamed up on the debate team.
Oh,
we had never been seen before, and we teamed up.
We did. We took them to the park.
That was pretty mature of us.
Definitely third year, when I turned 9. No, peak of my life. Gone down ever since. Third year.
That's
so
right.
Me and Neva Donnell we classified ourselves as fat and ugly. She was fat.
You
I was ugly.
Freaks to it as well.
Fat and ugly freaks. Yeah, that's more accurate. Puberty hit us. And we were no longer fat and ugly, and it was really an achievement.
I feel like everyone stopped being so like bitchy about everyone else.
maybe not in the girls section, but
I think I've gone the opposite way. I was very mature, and then all of a sudden I'm just fucking up everything.
I think I've matured like the past year. Don't you think? I have.
Nah, to be fair, I have matured because I got into Nesco.
That's a work in progress for me.
On the contrary, I'd probably say,
as if you've matured.
At the end of S4.
No, fuck off.
Yeah, I've moved on from, like, the haha, edgy, funny shit, because it's not funny anymore, and it's really, like...
Pretty racist.
Yeah, it is pretty racist and terrible.
I think I matured before grammar, and then kind of fucked up a little bit, and then we're slowly getting back there.
The only difference. Change in uni is that your voice is a bit deeper now.
And you're much taller.
Yeah. I mean,
and you still have braces.
Fuck these braces.
You also, when you mature, you realise that you don't like a lot of people because they are so immature.
Like, growth after you lose a friend and you realise that they're with the reason why you're so immature.
Yeah.
And, like, you look back and, like, they're still like that.
Yeah.
And you're not. And you realise that, like, that moment when that all happened, like, is... so worth it because it's like definitely like the right thing to happen.
No.
Sorted on my nat 5.
When do you feel like you matured, Chris?
Like nat 5, because I actually went and got like decent results.
But do you feel like as a person you've matured?
No. I remember in school I did, but not as like a person.
If I look back on my S1 self, I've definitely matured from there, but I don't like notice that I've matured. But I have, because I'm not an annoying little bitch anymore. Kind of. I think you've matured so much.
Definitely I'd say that in sixth year we made more of an effort to like speak to other
yeah,
people.
Speak to like out with you know the trio, the lads. You know, like we did branch out a lot. And I would say that it like could you imagine saying in even like fourth or fifth year that we were all gonna be going away with like the big group of us that are now. I definitely say that in a sense we opened up a bit more.
I think it was like parties
yeah,
like happening.
It brought more people together.
Yeah, and then people were like, oh wait, you're actually nice, like
you're
yeah.
not a bunch
yeah.
of fucking
fourth year for me.
Oh,
I was lonely
year.
When like people
no.
ditched me. I had to realize
I came along.
I was better by myself than I came along.
I mean, they were both laughing at poop jokes at the start of lockdown during Cards Against Humanity.
Poop is always
so someone would
funny,
put
though,
poop and they just laugh and that would be the winning card. So no, we have not matured at all.
I wouldn't say I'm not mature.
I wouldn't say everyone, like, everyone's matured at some point, but no one's, like, completely matured. Everyone's grown up at least a tiny bit, because, like...
I feel like it depends, though. I'm, like, mature when I need to be.
Yeah. When it
but
suits
not
the room.
When I'm not.
But if
exactly.
if you have the opportunity to piss about, then why
exactly.
not?
Why
not
you?
Do so?
I have to say the S3 at Lit Trip, I really feel like
it's
a
mature
people.
He went from a boy to a man.
Yeah. We don't
in
speak about the S3 at Lit Trip. You know unspeakable thing.
Stays on the at Lit Trip.
Let's just say...
A boy became a man on that.
Boy became a man. As maturity goes, Matthew hit a pretty massive growth spurt about a month ago.
Quarantine has grown. Like, I think in quarantine, Matthew's balls dropped. His voice is much deeper than it was.
I'd say fifth year.
Why fifth year?
Because I probably just through like exams. Like, I think I matured through exams because I literally like just stressed for like a solid 6 months, and we like. Well, I think we were a bit more mature as, like, a pair in, like, fifth year.
I've learned from my mistakes, don't take shit from nobody.
Yes!
Because what happens is they leave school and they drop off the face of the earth. The
problem is I've probably been too mature, but I've gone back to immature earlier this year, I think.
I have to say no.
I don't think at any point have I reached any level of maturity. I shit.
Probably.
I shit and I'm proud of it, so I mean, like, I'm basically still a toddler.
Do you think I'm mature? I mean, on some levels. Oh, there was that one time when, like, Hayden was sick and I got him some popcorn instead of more alcohol.
Fourth year is when I started taking classes a bit more seriously, basically. Because up in the fourth year, it was just a gigantic fuckabout, basically. So I was like, oh, damn. better start, like, paying attention in class and not pissing about and, like, shouting out random words and making noises and stuff around to the teachers. So, yeah, probably fourth year.
If you took recordings of my messages from first year, I'd go to jail. If you took recordings of me now, I'd still go to jail.
Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze. Country roads, take me home to the place. Moonshine, teardrop in my eye, country road.